guys. Today I'm gonna make kimchi. If you are interested, please keep watching. Here is my 6-pound napa cabbage I bought from Korean supermarket. It's pretty huge. We start with cutting the cabbage. So I cut a little bit of the bottom of it and then cut it in half. And then split it. Just like this. Cut into another half. So become like 4 big pieces. Then soak the cabbage in cold water before we salt it. Now it's ready to be salted. I use 1 cup of salt. Here I have the pink salt at my home. You can use sea salt too. Apply the salt between each leaf. Make sure you apply the salt thoroughly, especially the white part. I'm done salted all the cabbage. You could use less or more salt. Just make sure that the vegetable salt thoroughly. I'm gonna salt the napa for 2 hours, but every 30 minutes we're gonna come back and flip it. Next, we're gonna make the kimchi paste. Add 2 cups of water into the pot and then add 2 tablespoons of glutinous rice flour. Mix well, then turn on the heat. Once it starts to boil, add 2 tablespoons of brown sugar. Mix well and turn off the heat. Next ingredients are 1/2 cup of fish sauce, 1/2 onion, and around like 2 inches of the ginger, and the special ingredient that my sister recommend is pear or apple. I use Korean pear for this recipe. Then add 1/2 cup of garlic, 1 cup of chili pepper. This chili pepper is for making kimchi. I bought it from Korean supermarket. If you would like more spicy, then you can add more. Blend everything together. It will look like this. It look like Thai chili paste. Then taste and seasoning more if you like more salty or spiciness. Mix the chili paste into the cooked flour. Stir until smooth. Minutes passed, so we're gonna do our first flip. So flip all the vegetable. You can see that there's some water coming out of the napa already. Now we're gonna cut some vegetable to put into the paste. I cut carrot into thin strips. You can also add radish into the paste, but the vegetable that you must have is green onion. You can skip other vegetables except green onion. So you will need like a bunch of it. Here I have my green onion from my garden. It's from my without onion, so that's why it's so big. 60 minutes passed, so we are going to do the second flip. 1.5 hour passed, so we're gonna do the last flip, and you can see that the vegetable is pretty soft now and there is a lot of water coming out. We're gonna leave it like this for another 30 minutes. So total 2 hours of salting. After that, we're gonna rinse the cabbage with water thoroughly. Rinse between the leaves, and here I rinse the vegetable 3 times. You can gently squeeze the cabbage and leave the water drained out. We are almost ready to put the paste into the cabbage. So just put all the vegetable that we cut previously into the paste, mix it well. Now come to the fun part. We're gonna put all the paste into the leaf. You can split the Nava cabbage into another half before applying it. I'm wearing food grade plastic glove, and I also recommend you to using them too. So basically just apply the paste into each leaf, between the leaf thoroughly. The paste smells so good. I can't wait to try it. For the container, I use glassware from Pyrex. We are almost done. I've applied all the paste into the Napa cabbage. Make sure you press the cabbage firmly to remove all the air bubble. Then close the lid and leave it at the room temperature for 36 hours or until it fermented. You can also eat it right away, just sprinkle some sesame. Here I left my kimchi in my kitchen for 36 hours. The temperature in Washington was around 50 to 68 Fahrenheit, which was pretty cool. If in your area are warmer, you might need less time to ferment the vegetable. Oh wow, it smells so good. And the way to check out if it's been fermented, you just press the kimchi, and if you see the bubble, that means it's fermented. But you just need to test if you like the taste. If you want it to be more sour, you just leave it longer at the room temperature. Let's test it. I think it's not sour enough, so I'm gonna leave it for another 6 hours. Okay, here we go. Let's check after 6 hours. Let's test it again. This time I think it's sour enough for me. It's pretty good. Yummy! I'm very happy with the test. So I'm gonna stop the fermentation and put it in the refrigerator. I hope you guys give this recipe a try, and if you like this video, please subscribe, share, and like. Thank you so much. Bye.